every success story, there's a turning point. For the franchise with failed stints in Kansas City, then Colorado. For the team labeled Mickey Mouse by the world's greatest player, there came opportunity on draft day 1990. He wasn't the first goaltender selected that day. 9 picks after Trevor Kidd became property of the Calgary Flames, the Devils settled on Brodeur, age 18, Montreal native, photographer's son. Success wasn't instant, wasn't easy. His first uniform number, different from the one to be retired tonight.
Oates brought it in, the Leafs leaks the shot. Brodeur makes that ice glove save.
First game in the National Hockey League. Here's a 19-year-old kid who's been dreaming about this probably since he was 3 years old.
I remember a fresh-faced kid coming in, obviously excited, wide-eyed to be around the NHL, and nobody, myself included at that time, would have ever predicted the amount of success he was going to have.
Tucked out in front, Ferraro, a shot, and Brodeur able to stop it. The drive is into the glove of Brodeur.
47 games was enough evidence for the Calder Trophy voters in 1994. Brodeur was the NHL's top rookie. Within a calendar year of receiving such hardware came the ultimate prize.
McTavish open in the middle. Backhand shot, Brodeur! Martin Brodeur again. Shepherd in front. Backhander. Loose. Side of the net. Drake couldn't drive it home. The championship to New Jersey. The Devils win the Stanley Cup.
We had some good goalies, but there's no question we never had a goalie like Martin Brodeur in this system or in this organization.
As the flight of the butterfly goaltender became the NHL norm, Brodeur's hybrid style proved more conducive to enduring the grind of an NHL season.
You're getting banged into your face and all kinds of shots. You're going to get dinged up. But for him to be able to play through it, through all those things, was remarkable.
I would take Marty, you know, every day of the week. And just because, you know, there's few guys that had that whole package. And he had the whole package.
Tip back behind the net, shooting with the
Three shutouts in the Stanley Cup final were not enough to garner a first Brodeur Conn Smythe trophy as playoff MVP. But Jersey's cup runneth over for a third time. In the spring of 2007, his assault on the NHL record book was in overdrive. Bernie Parent's record for victories in a single season had stood for 39 years.
Save Brodeur, he pushed him back into the cage, but he holds on. Gagne, tough one in front, Carter is stopped by Brodeur. Back to Hatcher for the shot, shrugged away by Brodeur. Rebound, he sprawls, and does he have it? He does indeed. The 48th win by Marty Brodeur, a new NHL record.
In an unforgettable three-night span in 2009, his father and his idol-turned-rival would witness the all-time record fall.
Lapierre, and save Brodeur! What a save, what another save! Andre Kostyuchin, deep move in front, shot! There is company for Patrick Waugh atop the all-time wins list. For Marty Brodeur, 551.
Three on one the other way. Campbell a shot. Save Brodeur. Rebound. Big pile up there. Campbell drops. Brower the shot. Save Brodeur and another save on Kane. Shot one. Blocked out in front. Oh, and a pass stop made by Brodeur. One more by Barker. Block. And Marty Brodeur is the winningest goaltender in the NHL.
This is baffling when you look back and just see how many games he played and how many wins he has and how many shutouts he has. It just really is incredible that he was so good for so long.
Martin Brodeur has tied the NHL's all-time shutout record, 103. Gonchar fires, save Brodeur. The horn signals a new record. Marty Brodeur stands alone and he celebrates shutout number 104.
Every single year with him back there, no matter what the changes would have been up front, you know, they always had a chance to win the Stanley Cup.
And right back toward the network, ball and lifted on, that one did not go!
This was a team that didn't really emphasize its star players. The one exception was Martin Brodeur in goal. He was the Devils franchise.
If you go back to even some of his contract negotiations, where he took less money to stay with a team that gave him a chance to win, it was always about the winning.
In a timeline that spanned 15 head coaching changes, three ownership groups, and two buildings to call home, the one constant was Brodeur. The adage that defense wins championships, is it apropos in any venue more than this? The career of number 30, in a word, would be defined how?
Winning, that's what he did a lot of.
Just a champion.
Just excellence.
Clutch.
Thanks, Marty.